group participants while distributing questionnaires at a local fitness center.
I think they are admitting the wrong people. They are admitting the wrong people.
Yes. Yes. For example, when you want to, please close the door. For example, when you want to estimate the level of education or years of school in Kish, and if I select participants from your dormitory, for example, it's a selection bias. Why?
Because they are all the same.
Yes. Because all participants have, for example, high graduate or have high years of education.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
It's selection bias. And one of the your fine question in your final exam is exactly like this scenario. I'll give you some scenario. After that, I ask you some question about this scenario. For example, how could a systematic error how it occurred in this, for example, a study, and after that you you have to answer this question. Okay?
Okay.
So, in this scenario, self-selection bias, there are many types of
selection
bias, but right now in this class it doesn't matter the name of this error. For example, individuals who frequent a fitness center are likely to be more physically active and health conscious compared to the general population. It's selection bias. Okay? Another example. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And to eliminate selection bias in this scenario, researchers could consider following a strategy. For example, he or she should select a random sample from, for example, Kish Island. It's a best scenario or best option for you. For example, when you want to estimate the prevalence of physical inactivity, it's so wrong to select participants from a gym, for example, or a sport club. But you should select participants from general population, for example, a random sample from Kish Island. Yes? Another example? Please read this scenario, and after that, please tell me how could a systematic review have occurred, a systematic error. Systematic error have occurred in this study.
Well,
they
are the
result is overestimation or underestimation?
Overestimation.
Why?
Because
the most people that recruit to your study have diabetes, because you select your participant or your sample from diabetes clinic. Yes?
Yes, sir.
All of these are selection bias. There are many types of selection bias in a case control, cohort, and etc. But in this class, we focus on descriptive study. Descriptive study is, for example, a cross-sectional study. Because it's very complicated to talk about selection bias in case control study. It's very hard and it's very complex. So, selection bias can occur in this scenario due to, for example, following reasons. For example, non-diabetic cases, as you said, and another reason is healthcare seeking behavior. Please read this reason. These people have, for example, better life or better idea about information about your health, or they usually worried about your health. Yes? And what's your idea about eliminating this bias? What's your option? Yes, one of the most common approach for selecting unbiased sample is select participant from general population. For example, a random sample from general population, as I said before. Okay. All of this scenario were selection bias. Right now, I'm gonna tell you about information bias. What is information bias? Information bias is a systematic error in collecting data. For example, you want to estimate the prevalence of obesity in Tehran, and you use a scale that measure rate of participant higher than true value or reality. Yes, it's a information bias. Okay. And another definition of information bias is here. Imperfect definition of study variable or a fluid data collection procedure, and this error may result in misclassification or of exclusion and or outcome. And information bias is more common in analytical study. Analytical study like
who gives the answer of why and how?
No. Which of study designs are analytical?
Number-based.
No.
Why it is happening?
We have a lot of study design. Cross-sectional, mm-hmm. case control, cohort, and RCT.
RCT.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Cross-sectional is a descriptive study. Because the most important indicator that we can estimate from a cross-sectional study is prevalence. Do you remember previous session?
Yes.
It's descriptive. But in cross-sectional, but in case control and cohort and RCT, the main objective is determine or the assessment of their association. For example, association between A and B, X and Y. Okay? Information bias is a major problem in analytical study. But sometimes we face with the information bias in prevalence study or descriptive study. As I said, when you want to estimate mean of weight in a population or in a sample, if a scale, for example, do wrong, for example, do incorrectly, do how, for example, a systematic error, you cannot eliminate the effect of bias. Okay. In this slide, I'm gonna give you an example about information bias in prevalence study or cross-sectional. Please read this scenario and tell me, do we have a selection bias in this scenario? And after that, please tell me, do we have an information bias in this scenario? Please read this scenario. After that, I might ask you. For example, imagine that a study aims to estimate the prevalence of obesity in Kish Island. The researcher used random sampling technique to select participants from entire community. Do we have a selection bias?
No, sir.
No, sir.
A random population.
We probably don't have.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Do we have information bias?
Yes.
Why?
Specific brain scans.
Because the rate is higher than the there.
Yes, because the scale measures weight consistently higher than the true weight.
Sir, can we have the information bias other than the second system, that systematic error? For example, we recorded the major wrongly, or somebody lied us about his, the
yes,
true weight.
Yes.
We can also
yes.
have it.
Okay. There are many types of information bias, and as I said before, it doesn't matter, and it you don't need to learn or learn it. But I want to hear the name of these types of information bias: recall bias, interviewer bias, observer bias, and respondent bias. It's very modern and very complicated terminology in epidemiology. And after chance and bias, I'm gonna tell you about confounding. Confounding is very, very hard and very, very complicated. Before class, I was talking with one of your friend, and I told his it's very hard to speak about bias in one or two sessions, because there are many information about bias, error, and confounding in literature, and I have to compact or summarize all of this information into one session or two sessions, and it's so hard. Confounding, it's very complicated, but I think Dr. Fahim Farag told you something about standardization. Do you remember? Standardization. For example, when you want to compare two mortality rate among between two countries. Do you remember?
More chocolates, more.
Okay. Confounding is an important error in epidemiology, and bias and random error can occur in descriptive study and analytical study. So, random error and bias can occur in descriptive study and analytical study. But confounding or confounder bias or confounding can occur only in analytical study. For example, when you want to estimate the prevalence of obesity in Tehran, confounding doesn't matter. Why? Because confounder can occur in analytical study. But right now I'm talking about descriptive study. Okay? It's very important. Random error and or chance error and bias can occur in
descriptive
and analytical. But confounding
analytical
only can occur in analytical study. It cannot occur in descriptive study, because confounding results when the effect on exposure or intervention on the disease or outcome is distorted because of association of exposure with other factors. For example, and confounder have some criteria, and when you conduct a study, you should consider some rule or some properties for a compound. The first criteria or the first property is, for example, when you want to assess the association between coffee drinking or increased coffee drinking and pancreatic cancer, increased coffee drinking is X, is x. Increased coffee drinking to x, and outcome is y. Okay? Or for example, b. Here is b. And smoking in name z in modern references. But right now in this slide we named for example x as a confounder or as a confounder variable. But I think in Gordy's book or modern epidemiology book, usually we name the confounder Z and exposure X and outcome Y. But in this scenario, as you can see, factor X means confounder, potential confounder. Yes? Factor X is a noun risk factor for this is B. And factor X is associated with exposure A. Okay? When a variable have these properties, we call it confound. So you have to check these properties in all analytical studies. And there are many approaches for eliminating or for controlling confounder, and it's very important to learn it. And in the following, I'll tell you about the common approach for controlling or eliminating confounder variable in epidemiology. So, as I said, confounder variable have some criteria. One of them is confounder is a noun risk factor for disease. And factor variable or confounder is associated with exposure A or main your exposure. And you have to check all this property in your study when you want to do a for example, a study. And a lot of approaches, there are a lot of approaches for controlling confounder. During design of a study, we have three approaches, including restriction, matching, and randomization. What is randomization?
When we can randomly collect the samples.
Randomization. Which study design have randomization?
RCT.
In randomized controlled trial, the most important approach for controlling confounder is randomization. It will be a question for final. The most important approaches for controlling confounder or adjusting or eliminating the effect of the confounder in randomized controlled trial is randomization. Matching is more prevalent in case control study. Matching is an approach for controlling confounder effect in or confounder variable in case control study. And restriction is another option for controlling confounder. All of these three approaches are for during design of a study. For example, before you start a project, at the planning stage of a study design, you can do some approaches, including restriction, matching, and randomization for eliminating or for controlling a compound. But during analysis, for a statistical analysis, you have some option or some approaches for controlling confounder, including a stratified analysis and multi-hell analysis. It's wrong. Multi-hell analysis. Okay. It's an introduction for control of confounding because all these approaches are very complex for explaining in this session. But there are the point of this slide is that there are many approaches for controlling confounder during study design or during design of a study. We have three options or three approaches for control confounder, including restriction, matching, and randomization. Randomization is most important approach for randomized control trial. Matching is one of the approach for case control study, and restriction is another option. During analysis, we have two options, stratified analysis and multiple analysis, okay?
Sir, how matching and randomization controls the confounding? Can you
give
example? Because randomization helps us to distribute or to divide individuals randomly between two groups. And I think, for example, when a variable like age is a confounder, the distribution of age between groups are similar. And when the distribution of a variable is similar between two groups, that variable cannot create a confounder effect. It's very hard because it's very complicated. But randomization helps us to have a similar group. And when we have similar group, confounder cannot act on our measures. What happened?
Yes.
Okay. I have some slides, but it doesn't matter. I think it's enough for you to learn about the bias and random error and confounder. And however, I have a suggestion for you. I think Dr. Fosor, Dr. Feynman, and I should record some video about screening and some session, like for example outbreak investigation and etc. And we will send you this video sooner. But if you agree, I'll send you some practice about bias, random error, and confounding. Please send me your answer through email, just email. I sent you to an email address, tums.ac.ir and Yahoo yesterday. Please send me your answer, and I'll check your answer, and I'll send you a feedback based on your answer, and you can use it for final exam. My email address or